A car can round a turn on a flat road if the coefficient of friction is given. So this is the first time we've experienced this problem. Friction force is our centering force. So if you look at the free body diagram, always good to do. Weight is down, normal's up, friction is the centering force. So there's three forces. So if we start with our topic sentence, force net is the sum of the centering forces, and that's friction. There's no other force. There's no force pushing it out. We haven't brought up centrifugal force, but that's that mythical force. It does not exist. In fact, it's better that we didn't even say it. The only force is a centering force. So what do we always do in these topic sentences? We substitute in mass times acceleration for force net. In this case, mv squared over r is equal to, and the defining equation of friction is mu times normal. So back to the free body diagram, even though normal force doesn't look like it participates in this problem because it's not perpendicular to the motion, it is going to contribute to the friction force. So here we go. Substituting for normal force, it is equal to mg. You notice our masses are on both sides. So this is pretty cool. When you drop out your mass, you get v squared over r, acceleration, is equal to mu times gravity. And then, we're going to try to solve for velocity. And I love this one because it's a square root of rug. So if friction is, in this problem where there's friction providing the circular motion, the derived equation for velocity maximum is equal to square root of rug. Now be careful, please don't just memorize that because it's not always square root of rug, and students are tempted to do that at times. But it's a fun problem. So what does this mean? If the road is flat, it has no, the mass of the vehicle has no factor on how tight a curve it can make without slipping. Now, what they actually do on highways is bank those curves so that they do help have the weight contribute to the circular motion. But if it's perfectly flat, if you notice, the maximum velocity is simply dependent upon the radius, gravity, and how good your tires are. This mu is important. So if you've ever had tires on your car, your family vehicle that are balding, it's pretty tough to drive on those snowy roads and definitely make a turn.